We want to work toward getting everybody back in prayer and Bible study. This is perhaps one of the most difficult things because of schedules. It might be necessary to start having Sunday evening services in a few weeks. I know that many of us are very comfortable being home on Sunday evenings, watching the football games and relaxing and doing things that we can't do during the week. But my heart goes out for those that are not able to be here during the week, that's missing out on all of the prayer and all of the teachings during the week. Sunday morning is just not enough. Amen. Sunday mornings is just not enough. And I can sense when our spirits are a little dearth, a little spiritually, lacking. I can sense that. It's nothing like saints coming together to pray. You know, I'm the pastor of this church. I've been here for several years. And it's very difficult for me to maintain my spiritual momentum, motivation, and zeal and fervor without prayer. You know, I pray individually. Amen. All of us pray. In fact, if you've been around this ministry, you automatically will have the spirit of prayer. I mean, it goes with you, and sometimes you'll even try to pray. Just prayer just begins to what? Just begins to work its way, amen, through our mouths and through our hearts. Amen. But it's nothing like praying with saints that's committed to prayer. Amen. There's nothing like it. There's nothing like it. I think that there's something we'll always be missing when, we are supposed to help each other. You know, no man is an island. No man can make it without the help of a fivefold ministry gift. Also, we also need one another. Amen. So we just want to continue to do the things that will contribute to our spiritual growth and development. I know that like last Sunday we had probably twice as many. And see, what happens is that you have to try to find a time that you can get most members in prayer. Amen. Everybody need corporate prayer. Amen. I've already preached the sermon. I know some of y'all are ready for me to sit down now. But I've been married for let me see. This year, where's Brother Rob? Amen, he lost count even. This year will be our 50th wedding anniversary. Amen. Amen. I remember Brother Mariko even before we were married, we were engaged. I got saved just before, when I finished college, Sister Hill was still in college. We were courting, we were dating, she said. And I got saved during the process of dating, during that process. So that's when the Lord saved me. It was the summer of my graduation year, and I got saved that August. We got married that December. So it's been 50 years ago. If you count back 50 years, and you're pretty good in arithmetic, you can tell the year that we got married. Amen. But our journey with the Lord started with prayer. With prayer. Amen. After I got saved, I prayed that God would save my fiance. Neither one of us were saved. And then the Lord answered that prayer about 2 weeks after I got saved and filled with the Holy Spirit. She got saved and she got filled with the Holy Spirit shortly thereafter. And we got married, and that's all history. 50 years ago, we've been running for Jesus for a long time and haven't got tired yet. We did everything together. I mean, every time I was at church, of course, during the week, I was out of town. Of course, she was in town. I was out of town working. But whenever possible, whenever both of us were in town, we were always together in prayer. Everybody said, praise the Lord. That's the thing that brought us together in the initial stages. It was the prayer that we spent together on our knees, amen, at church. In those days, we had to get disciplined to pray. Sometimes they say, we want you to stay on your knees until you get your breakthrough in prayer. So you just had to learn how to pray. Amen. So we grew up in a church where we developed the discipline to pray. And as a result of that, that has tremendously enhanced our spiritual. 50 years, this is about the 50th wedding anniversary coming up December 1st. And not only did we do the prayer together, we did the word together. Amen. And we have separate times of prayer even now. Sister Hill prays on her own. I pray. We don't do it every morning together, but we are praying individually every morning. But the good thing about it is that every time I'm at prayer on Monday night, practically, she's here. Amen. Amen. Lord, 50 years of prayer on a consistent basis, every week, whatever nights were established for us to pray, and those nights that were established for us early on were Tuesday night and Friday night. Those were, and then we had Sunday morning and we have Sunday night. And so that's the reason why many times we lag in our spiritual devotion and commitment. And many times we, as believers, we are not like believers were when they had a stronger commitment to prayer and to the Word of God. This is what we are seeking to get back. You know, the more the month September was one of the greatest months that I can recall in a long time, where we just had prayer on a consistent basis every week, Monday through Friday at 5 o'clock. We had, you know, several that made a commitment to do that. And so this is the thing that makes the difference between the financial condition of a church, the spiritual condition, the numerical condition. It all starts with commitment to prayer. And things are just not going to happen by itself. Somebody will have to pay the price. So we didn't have a few people that were consistently praying, that were here in place on Monday night and Wednesday nights and special prayer meetings, it will be very difficult for this ministry to even thrive as well as it is. Amen. So I just wanted to, you know, my heart is that we want to have a time that all of God's people can come together and pour out their hearts to God. This is the way you get rid of all of the frustration and the anxiety and the contention and things going along with you. That's the reason why after 50 years, amen, sometimes when Sister Hill tell people that she's 69, people don't believe. She says, I just can't believe that you could be any over a day over 54 years old. Amen. They push her back 15 years. Amen. Praise God. So, I tell you, you got to have some way to release your frustration, your anxiety, and all of those things that's consistently, you know, the enemy comes to what? Steal, kill, and destroy. He's trying to press us. He's trying to create situations that we will have as much stress as possible. See, stress is the thing that kills you even more than a bad diet. And I don't know of any way, anything that will release you of stress than a good old Holy Ghost, amen, prayer meeting, when you can release yourself, pray it out, glory, hallelujah, worship it out, and just rejoice it out, and just let go and let God have His way. Amen. That's the thing that has kept us together for 50 years. Amen. And we ain't about to let nothing spoil it now by getting in a backslidden mode. As soon as you get in a backslidden mode, lose that zeal, that fervor, that commitment to the Word. Amen. That burden, that desire. Amen. Then the freshness. Amen. I know I'm preaching now. Y'all don't think I am. That's when the freshness began to what? Wane. Out of your relationships. That's when all of the friction and hostility and, amen, anxiety and frustration begins to rise up in the home. Amen. It takes prayer. I mean, it just takes more than just me personal prayer. I wish I could get that over. Amen. Amen. The key to anything is what? You got to have a what? You got to have a commitment to the Word. And you got to do something to what? To make the Word real. Amen. To make the Word real. If God says, I'm the Lord that healeth thee, that Word will never become real until we what? We meditate it. We got to get it in us. And we got to what? Work with that Word until that Word becomes what? Life to us. And I don't know of any way the Word will become more life than the what? Praying in the Holy Ghost. Amen. That's the reason why I pray as loud as I can sometimes. Because I let, yeah, amen, praise God. I'm going to stay carefree, worry free, anxiety free. I'm going to stay that way. Amen. Praise God. Because I know how to keep that stuff released on a daily basis. Amen. To tell the truth, if you come out on Monday night and just have a good old blowout, you know, it's almost enough to hold you all week. Do I have a witness? Did everybody say yes? I noticed that, you know, if you get your breakthrough on Monday night, on Tuesday night, Tuesday morning, Wednesday morning, usually the first thing that happens when you begin to rise up, amen, the first thing you're gonna gravitate to, yes, is what? Some kind of meditation. Yes. And before you get to your meditation sometime, then what? That language is gonna what? Begin to ease out of you. Hallelujah. I mean, it's just gonna happen.
Yes.
Amen. The Bible says the Word of God, when it's alive, is what? Life. Hallelujah. Yeah. How many can say life? Well, y'all don't know what y'all are missing. I just feel sorry for a lot of y'all.
Come on.
Because you need corporate prayer. Yes. You need, yes, corporate prayer. Yes. It doesn't make sense what church this says and how much we need and how much you need.
Come on.
To not find time in your schedule for what? For prayer. So, Sister Denise, I'm thinking about maybe Sunday evening. Let me see how many excuses we're going to have then. So I'm saying, that's the only day I have to do what I want to do, rest. Well, I don't know how in the world I can catch up on all of this teaching. All of this teaching for a whole year. And we miss out on all of it. And you know, Sunday morning, when worship time comes, we what? We just dries up. Tell me, what dries up what? See, you have a pastor that really cares about you, because if I didn't care, amen, I'm not here for the money, because I don't know even when I got a check last. See, when people ain't praying, the money, what, falls down. So I'm not here for the money. Amen. But I do think about a lot of these souls. I mean, y'all some good people. Amen. I like y'all a lot. Y'all some good folks. Amen. Hallelujah. But I want to see you praying, because if you're not praying, you're playing. Bottom line, and all of us, amen, I don't know, amen, there's a DB city I heard, if you don't change your direction, you're going to end up the way you're headed. If you don't change your direction, you're going to end up where you're going, where you're headed. Amen. So I just want to see a time, and I'm not even sure whether we want to make it possible, a time that all of God's people can come together and just cry out to God. Get rid of all of the anxiety, the frustration, the this and that, the poverty mentality, amen, and the, amen, and all of the negligence and all of that. Those spirits, we just got to get beyond.
Yeah.
Amen. Praise God. I believe Jesus is going to be coming, what, real soon? How many can say amen?
Amen.
And instead of, if we're not very careful, if you don't have somebody that's really looking out for your soul, instead of us getting closer and preparing ourselves for the coming of the Lord, we're going to what? What's going to happen? We're going to just get drift further and further and further away.
Come on.
Amen. I thought that when, as the nearness of Christ comes, I thought the closer that we ought to be getting to the Lord. That's what Sister Dorothy was trying to point us to. We need to get back to praying. So, you know.
Yes.
Yes. Amen. But how many know that how many love your bed a lot more than you love the Lord? Amen. Some of us love our sun tea a lot more than they would love the Word of God. But the Bible says man can't live by what? Your son to your bread alone, but by what? Every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God.
That's right.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
Right. Amen. I don't know. You see, revival always starts with what? Going back to the old amen to where we what? We got off. Amen. Got back, you know, it's almost old fashioned now. Get on your knees and pray. 9 o'clock on Sunday morning, everybody has an opportunity to come out here and pray. And I help y'all out even. I love y'all so much. I'll move it back to 8:30 and you have a whole hour. Rather than from 9 to 9:30. If I decided that, how many would hook up with us? See, people that's not going to pray, you're just not going to what? Pray. And somebody said, pray, believe and receive, or pray, doubt and do without. Amen. God could bless us a jillion times more than whatever we're involved in if we would just really, what, take that time and give it to God.
Amen.
Amen. You know, my dream is to get all of the brothers together. The sisters got together. I guess I was the only one then, and we had a brother or two came in during that 30-day period. Time or two. Amen. Sisters, amen, they paved the way. I mean, it was the most powerful demonstrations of the Holy Ghost that we have seen here in this long time. Suppose the whole church had been involved in that. Amen. Probably this morning, rather than just us sitting here, it probably would be a whole lot more, because prayer is the thing that what? Draws. When people come, they feel something what special. They feel a special anointing.
Yes, yes.
They feel something that's what really meeting their need and really satisfying that hunger and that desire. That desire, amen, to be loved. Amen. That's the thing that we just got to get back to. So I'm not giving up and giving in. Amen. I just gotta, amen. I'm praying now. I'm just praying now. Amen. That God will get us all on one page, one accord. I mean, this is not old-fashioned. The Bible says, if my people, which are called by my name, will what? Humble themselves and what? Pray. Amen. Seek my face. Everybody just says, seek my face. Now, it's time for all of us to get back to what? Seeking the face of God. That never get old-fashioned.
Amen.
Mm-mm. Amen. Some of the biggest churches that we've heard about lately, they're saying, Amen. Things ain't going the way they should be going because what? Amen. We got to get back to prayer. Amen. They feel the dirt. They feel the spiritual what? The deficiency in the realm of prayer. A lot of people flocking together. Amen. But on Wednesday nights and prayer meetings, what? Nobody show up. Just a handful of them. And amen. Praise God. See, some of y'all ought to be kissing or worshiping. Amen. The people that are on their knees praying. Amen. This place would have been closed a long time ago if we didn't have a group of people.
That's right.
I mean, we still might be going through the motion, but it would just be so dead and dry. I mean, even drier than it is. The only way we can change that, we just got to put, the Bible says, seek ye what? First. The kingdom of God. We got to put God again back what? First. Amen. And otherwise, we can make we can just continue to do things as we are, have a lot of motion, but what? No progress. Amen. How many know how it is when you, amen, just do things in motion, put things in motion, but you just don't get nowhere. Amen. So I'm willing. Amen. I'm willing, I'm willing to set a time that you can make it.
If it means something, well, I can come at 5:00 in the morning. Some said, well, y'all didn't cut me off, did you? All right. I can come at 5:00 in the morning. All right. Some said, well, that's too early for me. I'm going to make this. Okay.
Now, if 5:00 too early, what about 6:00? Amen. I'll be willing, amen, to come at 5 and just wait for you to show up at 6. I'll be praying. Amen. Because until we can get people praying, they ain't going to give no time. Because they don't have a mind to do it. They don't have a commitment. They don't have the motivation. He said, well, I ain't what I'm supposed to be no way, so why should I tithe? Tithe ain't going to help, amen, help the situation a whole lot because I know that's disobeying God, so amen, but I'm not like I'm supposed to be. Amen. I think that we ought to understand that the Bible says, let's hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and what? Keep His commandments. For this is the whole duty of what? Man. For God is going to bring into judgment what? Every work. Everybody just say every work. He's going to bring into judgment every work along with what? Every secret thing. And the way things are looking now, it's going to be quicker than you think. When you're going to have to face your entire life of negligence, if it's negligence in the spiritual realm, you're going to have to face that. Amen. The judgment seat of Christ is a message that we really need to look at because God is going to get into some whole lot of stuff. And a whole lot of things are going to be brought to the table. And all of, whatever you merit in terms of rewards or crowns or positions that you will actually be placed in during the millennial reign, amen, it's going to be contingent upon your commitment and your faithfulness. Well, when you were here in the local church and the things that you did, these are the things that determines where God will place you, if you are placed, period. Amen. What you do while you're down here. This is the dressing room. This is the time that we have to what? Prepare. This is the time that we got to do the stuff. We got to please God. Amen. Please God. Hallelujah. Amen. So I'm willing to roll back the time. Some say, I can't come at 6. I can come at 7. Amen. I'll just come on out here at 5 and stay to 7. Wait for you to show up. Because I want you to, amen. I want you to make it. Amen. Is that right? Amen. Praise God. So this is a little challenge this morning. I didn't plan to go this way, but I feel like this is something that we need. And that was the motivation behind Sunday evening, that maybe most saints can come on Sunday evening And we can share the word, and we can pray with them in the spirit, and just what? Support them and help them to get their breakthrough in the spirit. Now, if we can't do it every Sunday evening, I'll be missing too many football games with the brothers, right? Amen. What would be wrong with every other Sunday? All right, praise God. Okay, but I want you to just think about it. Amen. You need corporate prayer more than you think you do.
Yes.
Now, Sister Hill and I, amen, we know the importance of it. I wish we could communicate this, but, you know, this is a time that, you know, a day that many times we don't feel like we need what the old school had, like the prayer thing. Amen. But I think that prayer, Scripture says Jesus Christ is the same, what, yesterday, today, and what, forever. Amen. God's requirements are still what? The same. Amen. How many believe that?
Amen.
Amen. I've been trying to get things, you know, it's very difficult, and sometimes, I'm human too, sometimes I just feel like, well, just walking. Amen. Just walking. Amen. Somebody would take me in. Just so you would laugh. I think that you agree, but somebody would take you. Praise Him. Praise Him. Hallelujah. But I just believe that the answer that we're seeking and the things that we desire, amen, the things that we're expecting to happen and to transpire in our lives is only going to manifest through us
being in harmony with God's word.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Harmony with God's word. Amen.
Amen.
So I don't have a few minutes. I don't know. I just keep going out. Amen. But I just want to say,
man, it goes out again. I just give me a hand, right? Okay. Now, I've been sharing something that I felt that would be really good for everybody. Because I think that in the area of faith, the foundation of prayer has to be laid. In order to believe the word, Scripture says the word is what? Life. It's life. Amen. Life. Life to them that what? Find it. And you can tell when the word becomes life because of what? People get excited. Hey, hey, and I think that we need a whole lot of excitement about the Lord around here. A whole lot of excitement about the word. See, the Bible says the joy of the Lord is my what? Strength. You can tell pretty well where people are spiritually by the zeal, the motivation, and the fervency, and the way that they release the joy. Amen, in their worship or in their life. You can tell where people are. You can tell pretty well what page they're on. Amen. And I believe that the things that we are sharing with you are really designed to get you to a point where worship can become very excited, very. In other words, you go crazy worshiping the Lord, worshiping Him, worshiping Him. Amen. How many know that there's a blessing? And Scripture says if we delight ourselves in the Lord,
yes.
Amen, He would give us the desires of our heart. The Bible also says that rejoice, O ye lands, fear not, be glad, and the Lord will do great things. See, that's the prerequisite for the Lord doing great things, is what? Rejoicing. And being glad. And it just doesn't come until you what? You pay the time. I mean, you gotta give the Lord some time. Hey. Hallelujah. Amen. How many know a merry heart? Hey, hey, hey. A merry heart doeth what? Good. Lack of medicine. Amen. Well, I know one thing it does, it calls God to do great things. And that's what I want. Yeah, there's a whole lot of great things I want to see God do.
Yes,
amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Now, know if we are obedient, the scripture says the willing and the obedient, they'll eat what? The good. Amen. You know, 50 years ain't in a bad record.
That's right.
For, amen, we tried to pull a 21 wedding anniversary, a big one, but sister, I mean, 50 years rather. But Sister Hill, amen, she, we haven't come to agreement on that. She said it's too expensive. Amen. But 50 years is a pretty good record, right? And we're still happy with each other? I guess she is, honey. Next time I checked, she said, yeah. But more than that, boy, I got a jillion times more joy than we started out. Hey, praise God. Hallelujah. I have truly found that the joy of the Lord is what? Your strength. That's the thing that keeps our wedding, our marriage, what? Fresh. Amen. Old man come in, lip poked down, he's mad and upset, he's aggravated about something. He needs some what? Joy. He needs some joy juice, doesn't he? That'll cure it all. I can't think of a better example than Sister Judy Holman. Y'all know all of the little challenges that she has. A lot of them because she don't eat right. I got her. She's recognizing it. Amen. But there's a lot of natural things she's doing, and then there's a lot of challenges that she has, you know, ongoing. Amen. But I can tell, I don't believe that she would even be here with us if she hadn't been attending these prayer meetings. Because I see that during the prayer that she gets her what? She gets her release. She knows
the joy of the Lord.
That's right.
Hallelujah. And with joy, you draw water out of the wells of salvation. You know, her recipe is very simple. You know what her recipe is? Amen. Sometimes she even says, she said, well, sometimes I just really want to get up to a certain level, because at a certain level I get a charge.
That's right. Yeah.
A breakthrough.
Yeah.
The joy comes and the troubles, I'm going through, it just what falls by the wayside. And see, here's the thing
that Sister Judy says, she says, sometimes, amen, some prayer meeting, she said, I just can't quite get to where I want to get. Amen. Because some of us that's not here that could help her understood.